Loving and learning from Papa. Yeah, have you started the time?
Yes.
Okay. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Let me ask all of you. How many of you here have godmothers? Anyone? No one has godmothers? Really? Okay. Let me explain to you. Normally, in Singaporean context, we like to choose our godmothers. We say, we are very close to this lady, so we, oh, she's my godmother. And godmothers are special because they are people who we turn to when our own mothers fall short. They are people who we turn to when our own mothers cannot give to us the things that we require. But my godmother wasn't chosen by me. No, she's my father's sister. And she was chosen by my father to be my godma. And that's why I call her godma. So last Thursday was her birthday, and I was just thinking, I've learned quite a lot from my godma, and she's my sort of role model. And today I'm going to tell you three things that I especially like and learn from her. Now firstly, I'm going to talk about who she is to her friends. Secondly, who she is to my family. And lastly, who she is to me. So who she is to her friends. You see, my godma is a bit special. She has friends all the way from back when she was in JC, when she was in university. And I think it says something a lot about her character to have friends for such a long time. And one thing that we can learn from this is that actually it is important to keep people close and always be welcoming to them. Some of you may have lost friends in the past. I know I have. And I think that one major problem was that I was just not open enough to them, or I just did not accommodate them enough. So learn from godma and really take time to accommodate your friends, be open with them, and really take time to nurture that friendship. So yes, that's the first thing you can learn from godma, from her friends. Next is who my godma is to our family. You see, my godma is my aunt also. And every time we come together as a family, she's always the life of the party. Everyone is excited to meet her. Everyone is excited to see her again, to have a drink with her, to have dinner with her. And why is that so? I look and I see, you know, my father confiding in her, my uncles and my cousins confiding in her, telling her important things that are happening in their lives, and when they don't know where else to go, they turn to God. It's the same for me. I tell her things where I don't know the solutions of. And sometimes she gives me the solutions, or sometimes she just listens to the problems. But that is the next thing that we can learn from godma. Whenever people come to you, don't ever turn them away. What you should do is always give them that listening ear. Listen to their problems. And suddenly you will realize people will be excited to see you. People want to see you. Because they know they can trust you to keep their secret, and they can trust you to listen to them and understand them. And so that's the next thing that we learn from godma, from my family. And lastly, who my godma is to me. Now, I've told you a couple of times already, my family has some problems going on. You know, my mom, she has Alzheimer's. My father is not well-to-do. He struggles to make money. And honestly, my father is a great man. He never left the family. He continuously tried to give, but it is hard. It is hard to always be beside my mom. And the thing is that because of my mom's condition, what we need is a helper. Unfortunately, my father, is not well-to-do, and he can't afford this helper. So we are at a loss, and it's really trying on the family. But here comes godma. Godma is slightly better to do, and she offers to pay for the helper. She offers to pay for the helper that we need that does not even affect her at all. The helper does not wash her clothes, does not clean her house. All she does is help our family. And at a time where my whole family wanted to take a trip, but we couldn't afford to go anywhere far, my godma offered to pay for our plane ticket all the way to US to visit her, to stay at her house. And she brought us around. She paid for those tickets. And one thing that I feel that we all can learn from this acts of kindness and acts of generosity from my godma is that money should not be a priority in your life. Your GPA may be important, and your other things may be important, but what is really important is your friends, your family, your love for other people. Money is not important. Money is just a way that allows you to express your love to others. And that's the last thing I feel that we can learn from dogmas. Acts of kindness and generosity. So in conclusion, from a friend, learn to accommodate, learn to be welcoming to your friends. To your family, learn to give a listening ear. Learn to be a confidant to your people, to the people around you. And then you become the life of the party. And lastly, ladies and gentlemen, use money in a way that not only benefits yourself, but benefits the people you love. And that's the only way money should really be used, to express your love. And that is how I've loved and I've learned from Egotma. Thank you.